Alright y'all, what is up? It's Sasha. We're back here with another NBA video. As you can see on your screen, we're going to be trying to name the top 100 NBA players for this upcoming season, as said by ESPN. Now, as we all know, this quiz, or not the quiz, but the ranking, it's all really like controversial because ESPN made it for clicks. It's not really an accurate assessment of every NBA player for this upcoming season. It's made for discussion, it's made for engagement, I think we all know that, but still, I think, you know, at this point, it's going to be preseason started yesterday. By the time this video goes up, it started today as I'm recording it. But I think it's going to be a good time to sit down, take a look at what a major sports publication thinks is going to be the top 100 players. And yeah, we'll discuss it hopefully as the timer goes through. Just a couple things I want to say before I start. Shout out to King of the Fourth Quarter, Kenny Beecham, for the quiz inspiration. I've been watching for a while. When I first started watching him, he was big on the quiz grind, and especially the video that he posted, I think last week. It really just, and you know, it kind of inspired this idea. And also, the sports media outlet I write for, the basketball outlet I write for, the Lead Sports Media, we created a top 50 list of NBA players. I think we did a better job than ESPN did, and I think it's not very biased. I think it's all encompassing. There's a few things that, you know, once I go through it, if I go through it on video, I'll point out, but I encourage you guys to check it out down below. I'm going to link it in the description. And also the last thing is, I have not played this yet. I do not look at the lists. I don't really care about these lists at all. I haven't looked at them at all for the past 3 years because I know that they're all just for clicks, but I just still thought it'd be an interesting idea to record. So yeah, we're just going to go ahead and get started. I mean, as you can see, 15 minutes on the clock. 100 players, and we're gonna start off with the Lakers big two, the dynamic duo of LeBron and Anthony Davis. I think Anthony Davis is a top three, top four player. I don't know if he's number two. I think Giannis could be above him. I think it could be flip-flop, and also a very healthy KD is unstoppable and rightfully either the first or second best player in the league at all times when he's healthy. Of course, we got Giannis. Luka is going to have an MVP caliber season, I'm predicting. Kawhi, I'm not going to get into that. Brooklyn Nets, KD, as I was saying, one of the best players in the league, one of the most talented players, one of the most talented scorers of all time. And I hope he comes back and he's firing at full cylinders, as they say. Because a healthy Kevin Durant with Kyrie Irving, who I'm just going to type in right now before I forget, at number 25, are going to be a very, very dynamic duo. Also, I think Kyrie deserves a bit more respect than that. I don't think he's the 25th best player in the league, but hey, that's not something we're going to get into. Trailblazers this high is going to be Dame, and then Steph Curry, and then Harden, and Jokic to round out the top 10. I don't think Curry should be below Lillard. I'm a bigger fan of Dame than I am of Steph, but I think we're all forgetting how good of a player Steph is just because he got hurt last year and didn't play. But hey, we'll see how he plays without Klay. I still think he's going to play really well. It all depends. We'll just see when it comes to it. Jason Tatum. Then we got the Heat dynamic duo of Jimmy Butler and Bam Adebayo. I don't think Bam should be above Embiid, who is next, at all, but I think he should definitely be a top 20, top 25 player. I think there should be a lot of shuffling around in this thing. We see the next Sixers player is going to be Ben Simmons. We got the two Suns players. This is obviously going to be Chris Paul because of his tremendous season last season. Also Devin Booker because he's one of the best up-and-coming players. He's still really, really young, which is crazy to tell. So Booker... Okay, so Booker's not better than Paul according to ESPN. Again, Chris Paul deserves a lot of respect for how he played last year and everything like that, especially after his, you know, tenure in Houston. It wasn't the best, so I'm glad that he gets the respect that he's getting, but whatever. It's really also cool to see two Suns players in the top 20. That has not happened since probably Amari and Steve Nash, even if Amari was top 20. But we move Donovan Mitchell, because there's only 15 minutes and there's 100 players, so we gotta move. Zion, I'm not gonna touch on. Don't think he's 19. Paul George, get your bag, son. Get your bag. Jamal Murray, Brad Beal, Timberwolves, Towns, Raptors is Lowry. Lowry should be higher. Siakam, I was thinking that after the bubble, they would rank Kyle higher than Pascal just because Kyle played so much better and he was the reason, along with OG and other players as well. But he was a major reason that they made it so far in the playoffs and played so well in the bubble. But we're not going to get into that. Jazz is Gobert. Trailblazers, McCollum. Pelicans, B.I., Brandon Ingram. Hawks, Trae Young. Hawks are going to be a fun team to watch, man. Let me scroll down. Sorry if you didn't see that. Hawks are going to be a really, really fun team to watch. Probably a playoff team. Maybe even a mid-seed, 5-6 seed. And depending on who they match up with in the playoffs, if they make it that far, I think it could make for a really entertaining series. Grizzlies, John Morant. Shout out to the young guy. Celtics, Jaylen Brown. Bucks, Chris Middleton. We're ranking Drew Holiday higher than Chris Middleton, which I'm fine with. I don't have anything bad to say about that. What I do have bad to say is Russell Westbrook deserves to be higher than both De'Aaron Fox, Drew Holiday, Trae Young, Kyle Lowry. I'm saying as a Raptors fan, but whatever. The hate for Russell Westbrook is just going to continue forever, but it's okay. Middleton was up here. Celtics, Kemba Walker. Okay, Celtics, Marcus Smart. Thunder is going to be Shai Gilgeous. Pacers is going to be All-Star Sabonis. Pacers is going to be Oladipo. Pacers is going to be Malcolm Brogdon, I guess. Malcolm Brogdon. Raptors. Shout out Freddy for getting his bag. Mavericks going to be Kristaps. Porzingis. Magic, Vucevic. Shout out him. Grizzlies, Jaren Jackson. Alright. For the Warriors, that's gotta be Draymond. Yeah, it's gotta be Draymond. Like, Oubre's not gonna be on here, I don't think Wiggs is gonna be on here. And then Gordon Hayward, getting that bag. Alright, 45 players through, technically like 50 because of the players we got there, but so halfway there. This Nets player, that's gonna be Karis. Ooh. LeVert. Yeah, Karis. I'm telling you, the Nets are going to be a really, really, really fun team to watch. As well as Spencer Dinwiddie? Oh my god, what did you... I don't think you saw what I typed in. Up here, it said double-wa-dubba-dubba or whatever. It was whack. Actually, let's just do this so you see everything. I don't know why I didn't minimize it or zoom out in the first place. I just want y'all to see the whole thing. Alright, for the Nets, we have Dinwiddie. Nuggets, Michael Porter. Shout out him, man. He had a great he had a great bubble as well. Suns, DeAndre Ayton. Blazers gonna be Nurkic. Pelicans, man. Bledsoe. Alright, if it's not Bledsoe, Adams is gonna be the side. It's gotta be, I don't know, man. I'll just skip that for now. Rockets. I don't think PJ Tucker's gonna be this high. No. No, it's not him. It's gonna be Wall. John Wall. No, not John Wall. John Wall 81 is. I mean, he's been playing. He played well in the preseason game. He had flashes of his old self. I think he's gonna disprove this 81 ranking really fast. Rockets, Christian Wood? Don't tell me Christian Wood. Man, Christian Wood is this high. Bulls are gonna be Zach LaVine, Tobias Harris, Duncan Robinson's gonna be on here. He's not gonna be this high, but Tyler Hero, Dragic, Goran Dragic, Trailblazers, Covington. Speaking of the Rockets, Robert Covington, great 3-and-D guy. I love the way Robert Covington plays, man. It's always like the hustle guys that do it for me. It's always the guy who give their all out there. I mean, that's part of the reason I like Westbrook so much. I was a big fan of him back in OKC, and I still am, of course. Wizards. Is it Bertans? Dude, there's no way Davis Bertans 61, man. Hawks Gallinari. No. There's another Hawks player over there. Damn, there's gotta be Bogey, right? Bogdanovich. Bogdanovich. All right, cool. We got both of them down with that. Pacers. Miles Turner. No, Pacers. TJ Warren. Oh my God. Great bubble. Yeah, he deserves to be up that high. He had a really great bubble. Cavaliers. Sexton. Oh, I don't think Sexton's gonna be that high. Drummond, probably. Nope. Kevin Love. Okay, Kevin Love. Blake Griffin. Clips. Serge. Raptors. Anunoby. Wolves. Russell. Alright, who's that Pelicans player at 54, man? Don't tell me it's Lonzo, man. Okay. Pelicans player at 70. I'm gonna skip that for now. Jazz. Joe Ingles? Not that high. Okay. Mike Conley for sure. Gotta be. Alright. Then we got a couple Lakers players. Caldwell Pope. KCP's gotta be up here. Yep. Caruso's not gonna be up here. Yeah. Schroeder? Okay. Okay. Huh. Shoot, man. KCP, Caruso, Caldwell Pope. Marc Gasol. Alright, skip that for now. Magic, Aaron Gordon. Mavericks. Who they get? It's not gonna be Finney. It's gonna be Finney Smith, actually. Finney Smith, Dwight Powell. It's not gonna be Kleber. Who they get this offseason? Oh, Josh Richardson. Yep. All right. Josh Richardson. We got 12 players left. Got 5 minutes. I think we can get this. Spurs. DeMar. Disrespected as always. As always, disrespected, man. Pelicans. Who's that? Steven Adams up there? It is Steven Adams up there. Alright. Another Hawks player. John Collins? Such disrespectful, man. Bucks. Damn, who's on the Bucks? DiVincenzo. It's not gonna be DiVincenzo. Is it Brook Lopez. Alright. Kings, Buddy Hield. Pistons. We'll skip that for now. I don't really know. I don't know. We'll go back to it. I was gonna say Derrick Rose. I'm just gonna type in Derrick Rose anyways. It's not Derrick Rose. Clippers. Man, another dude on there. Oh, was the Lakers play Montrez? Alright, whatever. The Clippers question jarred my memory. Wolves, Clippers. Shoot. We got Ibaka. I don't know. Nets, Jared Allen. God, I wish I could spell Jared Allen's on there. Okay, Spurs. LaMarcus? Yeah, LaMarcus. Okay. We got only 4 left. We got Timberwolves player, Spurs player, Pistons player. Excuse me, and a Clippers player. Alright, let's think about this. Timberwolves. It's not gonna be a Kogi. I mean, I'll type it in anyways. Kogi. No. Who's their starting lineup gonna be? Alright, so it's gonna be Russ, D'Angelo Russell, Towns. Is Kogi gonna be starting? Oh! Rubio. Ricky Rubio. Spurs. We got Aldridge. We got DeRozan. We got Jakob Poeltl. No, it's not Capoto. It's gonna be Derek White. Alright, Derek White. 2 players left. One on Clippers, one on Pistons. Pistons. Alright. They played tonight, so we said Blake Griffin, we said Rose. It's not gonna be any new guys. Like the rookies. Oh, new guys. What's his face? Jeremy Grant. He played like crap today. But whatever. Alright, we got 1 left. Clipper player. Oh man, I got 2 players to think of a Clippers player. 2 minutes to think of a Clippers player. Who is this? Who is this? Who could this be? We got Paul George. We got, what's his face? Serge Ibaka. We got Kawhi, obviously. Harrell's gone. Lou Will? Did I type in Lou Will? It's not Lou Will. It's Pat Bev. That's me. It's Pat Bev. It's Pat Bev. Yo, let's go. With 1 minute 42 seconds left, let's go, man. I mean, it wasn't as easy as you think, but, like, once you go through, let me tell you this, without these hints, man, it'd be ridiculously hard to get it, but, definitely without the hints, I would not be able to get it, but, sheesh, I mean, we could look through this. Like I said, in this area, I told you what I agree or don't agree with. In this area, man, I think Porzingis should be higher, but at the same time, I don't know who I put him in front of. We'll just have to see how he plays alongside Luka, or if Luka's going to be more ball dominant and get more shots up. VO, man. Like this stuff right here, like VO, Kemba. Like, I feel like they should be higher, but at the same time, I don't know who to put him in front of. I think Marcus Smart deserves to be there. Like, I remember I said it, like, he didn't deserve to be there. But Marcus Smart does, because, like, on the offensive, or obviously not offensive, but on the defensive end, he's such a glue guy. He's a heart and hustle guy. You know, that's always so crucial to a team, a contending team especially. And then on the offensive end, we saw, like, in the bubble, he absolutely torched the Raptors, man. And I remember that was crazy. He literally hit, like, some of the biggest shots in his life during that Raptors series. And I don't mean that like a game-winning sense. I mean that in just like he was going off. Like, you could confuse him with Steph Curry on the floor. That's what I'm saying. Lonzo, man. this is Gordon, by the way. This is whack. Hero, low, lower. Covington, higher. K-Love, lower. Ibaka, higher. Anobi, higher. You see my bias, but you feel me. Like, these guys, they're such good players. Bledsoe higher, bro. I would put Eric Bledsoe in front of Lonzo Ball any day. And D'Angelo Russell. You tell me Lonzo Ball is a better player than Goran Dragic? I mean, probably. But then D'Angelo Russell? Nah, that's disrespect. Duncan Robinson's really high already. I mean, you could move him down, probably. I probably wouldn't have gotten Otto Porter, to be honest, but I'm glad I typed in... whose name? Michael Porter. I'm glad I typed in Michael Porter, because Otto Porter, I probably wouldn't have gotten... Yeah, nah. It's whack at the same time. Hold on, let's see what the comments say. ESPN super for this list, bro. And ESPN's fake news. All right, I feel that. But all right, yo, that's been the quiz. I think it was pretty well. I feel like if I wasn't talking about some of the players, I would have gotten it done faster. But all in all, I got 100%. And as it says right here, my parents probably are super proud of me. But yeah, if you made it this far, make sure to leave a like, subscribe down below, and follow my Twitter at Sasha_Podzorov, man. Gonna be posting basketball content as the season heats up. And also, make sure to check out the lead, man. We got some good stuff cooking. And as an organization, man, we're growing like crazy. So I appreciate y'all if you made it this far. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed.